Let's say you had an HIV test. What are the reasons why the test result may be false positive or false negative? We have summarized it for you. A false positive HIV result is when a person who does not actually have the virus receives a positive test result. This may occur due to errors in home tests, the presence of other health conditions, and facility or provider-based issues. The fourth-generation testing platforms used to test for HIV have a specificity of approximately 99.5%. Meaning that if 1,000 uninfected people are tested, around 5 people, 0.5%, will have a false positive result. The most common causes of an incorrect HIV test result include the timing of testing. After a person contracts HIV, the body does not immediately produce antibodies to fight off the infection. This is why HIV tests have a window period. The period between the person contracting HIV and the time a test can detect its presence in the body. Common cause of a false positive HIV result is when the test detects antibodies for a different infection or substance. For example, recent viral infections may cause a false positive ELISA test result. Schistosomiasis infection can also lead to false positive HIV results. A person with babesiosis had a false positive HIV test. Certain other conditions that may cause a person to have a false positive in an ELISA include Epstein-Barr virus. Autoimmune disorders, such as lupus and rheumatoid arthritis. Lyme disease. STIs, such as syphilis. Having recently received a vaccination, such as for flu or hepatitis B. Prior pregnancies. Receiving multiple blood transfusions. Receiving gamma globulin or immunoglobulin. A false negative result happens when a person who has HIV receives a negative result after being tested for the condition. False negative results are less common than false positive results, although both are rare. A false negative result can happen if a person gets tested too soon after contracting HIV. Tests for HIV are only accurate after a certain amount of time has passed since the person has been exposed to the virus. This window period varies from one type of test to another. False negative results most often occur when people test in the first few weeks after infection. During the window period of a test. At this time, the markers of infection, P24 antigen and antibodies, that tests look for may be absent or scarce. Tests cannot reliably pick up all cases of infection during the window period. The probability of a false negative result is 0.01 at 80 days post-exposure for third-generation tests and at 42 days for fourth-generation tests. Testing too early, before the window period, can result in a false negative result. If a person takes an HIV test 3 months after exposure to the virus and the result comes back negative, this result is considered sufficient. The right time to get tested is 90 days after a possible exposure, since this is considered the time where more than 99.7% of people have fully developed HIV antibodies. False negatives have also been reported in people taking antiretroviral medicines, whether as HIV treatment, pre-exposure prophylaxis, PrEP, or post-exposure prophylaxis, PEP. And lastly, mishandling samples, mislabeling, and mixing up specimens can occur during testing. At-home tests may also be prone to user error. Some testing devices may rely on subjective interpretation when reading a result, leading to incorrect interpretations when results are borderline. We would be very happy if you like our video and subscribe. Goodbye.